A big round of applause. Uh-huh. Maestro David Eliaho on the violin. rock like this together, it's a little bit hard to say goodbye to it. It's such a rare opportunity in life. We have a chance to be with such great people, to share words of Torah, to sing. Let our hearts connect a little bit more. Open ourselves up a little bit to what we all really want to feel. About Shabbat is that no two Shabbases are the same. We do different things, maybe with different people. We're eating the same foods, but somehow each Shabbat has an energy of its own. Energy that you really just can't describe, you can't explain. Maybe you can't even tell anybody who wasn't there with you. I think this was one of those Shabbases. Can't really describe it. It just is what it is, and all the beauty that makes Shabbat the perfect gift from the Almighty. You know, we think that we come in on Friday night, and we light two candles, one for Shabbat and one for Zohar. Maybe it's a little bit how we feel with each other also, that we feel a little bit separate from each other. We come in, we stand there by the candles, we look at them, we make our brachot. The candlesticks are separate. By the time we get to Havdalah, we take a candle, and the wicks are intertwined, weaved together like wine. Maybe that's a little bit how we're supposed to feel at the end of the Shabbat. Come home again, we're like one. Before we feel more connected, certainly to ourselves, the Shem and the Guf, the body and the soul, came together once again. Feel more connected to Hashem in His presence, in His palace for 25 hours. Coming in Friday afternoon, some aren't the same people we see tonight. We've glimpsed a little bit of each other's souls. And as a result, we're looking at each other a little differently as well. And now we're going to make blessings for the Havdalah. Blessing over the wine. And the wine for us is that symbol that always describes what this world is all about. To get to that beauty of the wine, you have to break the grape, and you have to crush the grape, and you have to squeeze it. You have to ferment, let it sit. In other words, this world, if you want to get to that beautiful wine, you have to look behind the surface. You have to break it down a little bit. You have to crush it. And you have to think about it a little bit. There's something so delicious on the inside. You know, we always take wine and we go from one point of elevation to another point of elevation. We always remember that under our chuppah, we began our wedding on that blessing over the wine which the Misad HaKadosh, the rabbi, made. Friday night, we go into Shabbat over a cup of wine. Now tonight as well, we're going to go into the week over a cup of wine. What type of elevation can there be from the Shabbat? The Shabbat is the highest point. It must mean that the week that we're experiencing now is an elevated week. It's not the same as last week. It's now gone through Shabbat. We're going to a completely new wholeness, a new week, an elevated week, not like the one before. Over the spices. Friday night, three angels visited us. We sang Shabbalech to them. And part of their job when they came to see us was to give us something very special. Those angels gave us Nishamaya Tera. an extra level of soul. And that this Shema came from the highest place in the Shemayim next to the Kisei HaKavod. Those angels did their job. They dropped off that soul. They placed it inside of us. But now in Mosi Shabbat, we have to give it back. It goes back to Shemayim. We'll wait for next Shabbat to feel it again. Sadness in that. There's a little bit of pain when Hashem experiences. When we smell the spices, it alleviates that pain just a little bit. The sense of smell is the purest sense that we have in our bodies. It's a sense uncorrupted by any sin. Just feeling that smell helps the Neshama ease. As the Neshama Yitanah goes back home.
Thank you.
Good luck, everybody.